everybody. My name is Matt Elliott, and I'm here at the RV Corral in Eugene, Oregon on Highway 99. Today I want to show you a trailer that just came in. It's a brand new Hideout, and it's a beautiful little trailer. One of the things I like about this trailer is it's really roomy. It's got a big slide out, but it's not a big trailer. In fact, it only weighs 4,400 pounds. So this is going to go well behind a lot of your lighter half-ton style and some of your SUV vehicles that are kind of limited in how much they can pull. This is a really good choice. There's a lot to talk about, so let's get started. First of all, I want to talk about the sheet metal exterior. A lot of trailers have fiberglass exterior. A lot of trailers have this kind of exterior. Sheet metal is an excellent exterior for a coach because it doesn't weather and because the construction process does not require lamination. So when you look at a fiberglass trailer, usually those walls are built by laminating layers of material together, and there's difficulty down the road years and years where that lamination process fails either from water intrusion or some other things, and you see delamination. Well, you don't have to worry about that on this coach because it's not laminated. And the sheet metal doesn't weather. In fact, my dad's got a boat that's older than I am with this kind of exterior on it, and it looks like new. So the sheet metal exterior is extremely durable, and it weathers very, very well. Okay, so that's a plus on that. If we look at the front here, I want to show you this really unusual battery box. This trailer has a 100 amp hour lithium ion battery. It's part of the package from the factory. It's factory installed, and it increases the amount of charge you have available by multiples from a regular lead acid battery. They're more reliable, they last longer, and they are just awesome, especially for dry campers. This is coupled with a 200 watt solar panel, so you have continuous charging for this battery. So while you're using it, the battery's being replenished, and while you're storing it, it's being topped off at all times. It's such a good idea. I love this setup here. Okay, now let's walk around. I want you to notice that there's a very large storage area underneath, and that goes all the way through. And you could see some controls on the other side. That's your solar controller, your battery disconnect, stuff like that. We have the Moride step above steps, these are called. And the beauty of them is they don't make your trailer bounce when you walk in and out. And they're a lot more stable too. So if you got sore knees or ankles or things, you have a lot more stable platform to walk in and out of. Now, this one here has a single axle trailer, and that's okay because it's light enough for a single axle. A lot of times people talk about the number of axles as a very important feature, but it's really, really just a function of weight. If you have a real heavy trailer, you need two axles. If you have a real light trailer, you need one. This still has nice cargo capacities even with this one axle. Okay, let's take a look around here. One of the things I like on this rig, and you could see it's a walkable roof. There's a sticker here that says it's a walkable roof, and that means I can get up there, walk around, look at my seals, remove debris, take care of my roof. That's a great thing to be able to do. But it's also prepped for an on-the-go ladder. And see, what this little bracket up here is it's where you set a ladder that's collapsible. And if you want, you can get one of these collapsible ladders, and they don't take up all the storage. So I could just put it up when I want and fold it up when I don't want it. And I don't have 36 holes in my trailer where all the screws for the ladders go. So this is such a great advancement on ladder technology. And it's funny to say ladder technology. They've had ladders for thousands of years, but that's a really good idea. Okay, now we take a look here. We're gonna see, here's your slide out. And it's a big one. You see how big this slide out is? So for a smaller trailer, it's really nice to see, and wait till you see what's inside. In fact, we're gonna go take a look at that right now. Okay, so now we're taking a look at the inside of the 186SS Hideout. And the thing that you notice right away when you walk in is it's just roomy. It's really big. And you know, there's a couple of reasons why. First of all, they don't have the bedroom closed off. So whenever you do that and you put a wall here at the end of the bed, it makes everything feel really tight and small inside. this whole thing is living space. It makes it really spacious. And that is a, you know, a full 60-inch queen. A lot of smaller trailers don't really have a full-size bed, but this one does. Now, in the slide out, when you get a small trailer, usually you don't have a couch and a dinette, but this has both. This flips down and makes a bed, and then you have all this storage behind. There's all kinds of storage underneath the benches on this booth, and it folds down and makes a bed easily. So there's a lot of storage as well as a lot of people space. There's even a fold down armrest with a cup holder here. If you look down under the slide, drawers, 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 lots of places to store stuff. And there's even a plug-in you can use down there. And you see these yellow stickers on some of these plug-ins. Those yellow stickers mean that this is pre-wired to take an inverter. And if I put an inverter on the coach, then I can run some of these 110 type appliances right off of my battery power. So that's a kind of a cool technology that's available on this coach. Now, if we take a look at the galley, we'll see we have a nice small, of course, we're trying to conserve some space and weight. Two burners is adequate for most people. And then that gives us more storage down below. We've got a great cabinet down here, plenty of room for a garbage can. And we've got a microwave oven, nice storage up here. And then this is interesting. This is a new kind of fridge, and it really works well with the battery system and the solar panels we have. This is a 12-volt all-electric fridge. And so the idea behind that is I'm going to use power that I'm getting from the sun and from my stored power and from when I'm driving to keep my batteries up. I can just run this on batteries. It's very efficient. It's got plenty of power to run this fridge all the time. And of course, because it doesn't have the propane stuff, it's a lot bigger. So would normally be a 6 cubic foot fridge. And I believe it hauls about 10 cubic feet in it instead of 6. So that's a huge improvement on your food capacity. Now, another reason this coach is so open inside is because we have the bathroom in the back. It's not in the middle. If you look at almost all these trailers, when they're small, you know, if the bathroom's in the middle, it feels like it's really a bottleneck kind of a feel. But this trailer doesn't have that problem at all. Also, I want to point out this has a Girard on-demand hot water heater, something you normally don't see on a trailer in this price point. On-demand is great. That means that I can just make my hot water when I want. I don't have to heat it all the time. That really saves resources. And then in the back, you have this great big wardrobe, lots of shelving. Whoop. Down there, plenty of space. So that's a quick look at the new Hideout 186SS, 200 solar package, 200 watts of solar, 100 amp hour lithium ion battery system, and so much more. This is a great trailer. I hope you enjoyed the video. I'd love to show you this in person though, and I'd also be happy to talk to you and answer any questions you have. So I'm Matt Elliott. You can reach me at 541-954-8495. Thanks a lot. You have a great day.